So can we. Together think. The absolute need of a good society. The society is what you are, what we are. Society doesn't come into being mysteriously. It's not created by God. Man has created this society with all the wars and all that's going on. We don't have to go into all the horrible details of it. And that society is what we are. What each human being is. That's fairly obvious. That is, we create this society with all its divisions, with its conflicts, with its terror, with its inequality, and so on, so on, so on. Because in ourselves we are that. Which is in our relationship with each other, we are that. We may be fairly tolerant, fairly affectionate in private relationship, even that's rather doubtful. But with regard to the rest of the human beings, we are not. Which is again fairly obvious when you read the newspapers, magazines, and actually see what's going on. So, good society can only come into being, not in the future, but now, when we human beings have established right relationship between ourselves. Is that possible? Not in some future date, but actually in the present, in our daily life. Could we bring about a relationship that is essentially good? Good being, without domination, without personal interest, without personal vanity, ambition and so on. So that there is a relationship between each other which is based essentially on, if I may use the word, and I hope you won't mind, love. Is that possible? Can we, as human beings, living in this terrible world which we have created, could we bring about a radical change in ourselves? That's the whole point. Some philosophers and others have said human conditioning is impossible radically to change. You can modify it. You can polish it, refine it. But the basic quality of conditioning, you cannot alter it. There are a great many people who think that. The existentialists and so on, so on, so on. Why do we accept such condition? You're following, I hope, what we're taught. Why do we accept our conditioning, which has brought about this really mad world, insane world, where we want peace and we are supplying armaments, where we want peace and we are nationalistically, economically, socially dividing each other, We want peace, and all religions are making us separate, as they are, the organizations. There's such vast contradiction out there as well as in ourselves. I wonder if one is aware of all this. In ourselves, not what is happening out there. Most of us know what's happening out there. You don't have to be very clever to find out. Just observe. And that confusion out there is partly responsible for our own conditioning. We're asking, is it possible to bring about in our souls a radical transformation of this? Because only then we can have a good society. Where we won't hurt each other, both psychologically as well as physically. When one asks this question of ourselves, what is our deep response to that question? One is conditioned. Not only as an Englishman or a German or French and so on, but also one is conditioned by various forms of desires, beliefs, pleasures, and conflict, psychological conflict, all that contributes to this conditioning and more. We'll go into it. And we are asking ourselves, thinking together, because we are thinking together, I hope, can this conditioning, can this human prison with its griefs, loneliness, anxieties, personal assertions, personal demands, fulfillments and all that. That's our conditioning. That's our consciousness. And our consciousness is its content. And we are asking, can that whole structure be transformed? Otherwise, we will never have peace in this world. There will be perhaps little modifications, but man will be fighting, quarrelling, perpetually in conflict within himself and outwardly. So that's our question.